Hey guys, Janus here. In the last video, I talked about something called flow locking. As many of you know, the venous system has specially designed structures known as valves that stops blood from flowing backwards. In the past, I have repeatedly spoken out against exercises like jelking or clamping-based techniques that either force blood backwards in the veins or expose them to dangerous pressures, and here is why. Our soft tissues are heavily reliant upon the relationship between the arterial and venous channels, specifically the flow locking valves allow for. Anytime a soft tissue structure of our body undergoes compression, either from an internal-based force such as a muscle contraction or an outwardly exerted bout of fluid displacement such as a squeeze, the venous-based valve systems ensure that blood will generally be displaced in one direction. The way this plays out in the case of a muscle contraction, pressure is exerted upon the arterial vascular networks within the muscle belly, which leads to fluid displacement from those given areas. Because of the valves in the venous system, when this fluid displacement exerted by the muscle contraction occurs, instead of blood being pushed back towards the heart, it is instead forced out of the muscle belly and into the outlying venous networks. This is an example of flow locking. Centering the discussion on the topic of PE, anytime we stretch, squeeze, or otherwise compress the male member, blood is forced from the arterial network spaces deep within the corporal bodies and into the outlying venous networks, which exist predominantly in the space between the tunica albuginea and buccal fascia. Practically applying these lessons, I began to revisit my work on the Macropulse while also reflecting on the purpose of the male member. During a sexual encounter, whenever a male penetrates a female, the vaginal canal will exert fluid displacement that first occurs in the glands and the top portion of the male member. Taking into consideration the chronological flow of events that occurs during penetration, I took a closer look at the vascular structures that present within and around the glands, along with the shape of the penis itself. What I found was an unusually large cluster of veins that exists just below the glands, along with a narrowing of the corporal bodies, which appears to allow for an exploitation of distally applied fluid displacement, such as first occurs in the initial stages of penetration. Upon making this observation, I began to wonder if the squeezes exerted during the Macropulse would have a more pronounced effect if applied just below the glands on the first inch or so of the shaft, and I began to tailor my approach accordingly. One of the very first observations I noted was how quickly I could increase both my fullness and hardness by applying the Macropulse squeezes within this specially designed zone. Taking into account the structures that present within the last inch or so of the male member and the tenets of flow locking, I quickly surmised that the male member is designed to exploit shear stress-based nitric oxide release such as would occur during penetrative fluid displacement, thus increasing both fullness and rigidity so as to facilitate penetration while also increasing structural stability. The take-home lesson from all of this is that by exercising the penis in a manner more closely resembling the act of penetration, we can greatly increase the efficacy of a given exercise session. So, as I covered in the last video, when performing the Macropulse, you will experience more positive outcomes by applying its cyclic squeezes along the last inch or so of the corporal bodies just below the glands. Well guys, that's it for this week's video, and as always, I'm your host, Janus, signing off.